Hi everyone. Let me know if you guys are able to hear me out. You can just share that in the comments. Great. How are you all doing? How is the Sunday being for you guys? It's really great that you guys showed up even on Sunday, where people just relax. But these days, everyone is, every day is a Sunday most of the times. Prabhati, I can see. I'm all great, yeah. Don't call me sir, yeah. Vijit is fine with me. I hope you and I are visible very well right now. There's not much issue. I'm sitting a little alone out of Kenya, not at my residence at the moment, so it's kind of tough still managing tech, thanks to the tech guys. So I assume all of you have a keen interest in writing over here. Is it that? Because that reason maybe has been your key motivation to join this platform and listen to how can one develop a novel or maybe a big story line. So any of you ever have you can just say yes or no in the comments, like any of you ever has thought of yeah, it's been, I love writing, so I should write a book. Yeah, there's a story in my mind, but I'm not able to pen it down. There's a story in my mind, I'm able to pen it down, but I don't know how to manage the scenes, manage the characters, manage the people. It's honestly, guys, it's very simple. It is complicated, yet very simple. You can assume that my statement is very much of an oxymoron, but that's how a story has to be. So, let me just share. Try sharing a screen, or maybe. So on the first case, what has to be on my priority list? That there has to be a central idea which should drive your story, guys. There should be a one central idea which the story is just, it can be one line, it can be one sentence, it can be even one word. And you have to revolve your story around it. In my case, when I published my first book, it recently got The Benign Guest. I had that thing, I had that. It's so let me tell you my journey. How was I able to pen it down? It happened a couple of years back when I was just at my office working like a human maniac, a human robot, 9 to 5, which काम होता नहीं था. because that's what I thought that life has to be ahead. And I have that knack of writing since years, just like you guys. And I still do. It's not like I don't have it now. I still do, and forever will have it. So one day I just woke up in the morning, and it was a dream to me that I had some or the other, word crossed my mind, and I was like, geez, this is something very new to me. And new in the sense, it really provoked me to think about it often, very often. Every now and then, when I was at my office, when I'm traveling somewhere, that particular thing which I witnessed, it can be. So for me, I saw a storyline. It's just a storyline cracked up in my mind about a girl who has come back to take revenge. Just one simple lie. Revenge for what? We don't know. Revenge for what reason? What? How will she do that? For against whom she wants to take the revenge? I don't know that. But I had that just one line. A girl has come back to take revenge. This is the one simple line which came in my mind, which has to be the idea. And I'm unaware of how did that happen. For that, we really need to just take a pen and a paper. If you guys can take a pen and paper, write your idea down and just start pulling out words from it. And in a big page of paper, just put your thought right down there. That maybe it can be written to a guy who goes to Australia to chase his dreams. Simple life. A guy goes to Australia to chase his dreams. How does he go to Australia? What is the struggle in India that he could face to visit Australia? How is the journey? What kind of people will he meet over there? What kind of life will he experience in Australia? How will his character transform while being in India to while being in Australia? So that's how a journey goes. That's how your idea can turn into a novel. And for that, you really, really need to just pen your one idea. So let me hear from you guys in the comments. Like, do you ever have had that one such idea that you think that I should make a story out of that? Any, you can just share that if you have any. The comments, the forum is open. Like, you can share yourself here. Oh, Disha has said yes. Rupal. Too many to count. I feel that, Prakriti, because while I was writing, this is not the first time that I was writing a story. Years back, I tried to write a love story, and I completed few of it, and in the end, I was like, nahi karna. I'm not getting that vibe from that story. So it's going to happen. So, but for that, you really need to think a lot on that. A girl who was innocent now knows how to people. That's a brilliant storyline, Sheetal. See, even the simplest, I will say, Sheetal, that a guy or a girl grew up in an orphan and became an entrepreneur. Simple, just one line. A girl who wants to get married to the childhood love of her life. Just simple, small lines can make a big difference. For me, I just knew, guys, that I have a story that a girl has come back to take a revenge. I didn't know what kind of revenge, how will she take. But slowly, when I started thinking about it, I started planning ideas around it. And I got to know mythology is one of the factor which can influence the people. I had a murder mystery is another thing which can the girl should take revenge on. Or maybe it's the love angle that she was in love with someone and then he betrayed her and now she's taking the revenge. There were multiple ideas going in my mind. And I was like, you have to be very, very script for that to happen. Very script. Because a mind is very small. It's just small meters, I would say, a space. But the capacity of ideas it could have is in tons. And you need to, clutter it down to small, or even one, two, or maximum three lines that you have to work on. Purpose of life. I had an idea about a love story using 1947 and 2021. Brilliant idea. That's a brilliant idea, actually, because See, every idea I'll tell you is brilliant. If it's coming from your heart, if it's coming from your soul that you have to tell one or the other story, just go for it. Even if it's from your own life. Like, in case a girl who scored tons of marks in 10th, but now she's struggling. Just a simple line. Or a girl who was not good in math. See, a girl who was not good in math is one simple story line. This is a small sentence. Man who just, who was like an Einstein, but in future became like, his condition became like a beggar. So how the journey flows is we have to think, we have to jot down the ideas. And that's only going to happen agar tum log acche se sochoge. No, nothing can happen until unless you keep your mind working. You have to keep your mind working, but don't stress it. Stress is one of the key factors that will stop you from giving thoughts. Story hai mind mein, line hai, thoughts lane hai, relax. You don't have to be in any hurry. Good stories take time. Great stories take years. So it's just that you have to be very relaxed. Calmly just sit down with a book and a pen. Enjoy the weather. It's the monsoon right now. Enjoy the weather. Have a cup of coffee, tea, whatever you like. Or maybe if you see, many times many people love to listen to music while writing. Listen to music because music is one of the major factors that plays into writing, guys. It's my personal feel which I've experienced. It is very subjective. To other people, it might come differently, very differently. But if you're writing a particular scene in a story, if you're just writing a particular scene in a story, if it's writing to love, and just imagine if I'm writing a scene which is very emotional, intense, romantic, and a song like Tumhi Ho comes in, immediately the boost of my thoughts would be given. If many a times you purposely have to do that without a question. Problem is that I face that I don't know how to develop the idea in a systematic way. Ideas never have a systematic mind because that's why you call it an idea, guys. Idea does never, like, it never has a systematic problem because if you call your idea systematic, then don't ever expect your story to be a systematic one. It's strange, but that's true because the more you want your idea to be systematic, the keep it informal, guys. Keep it informal. Very much jumbled. You can just put an outline. You can just play with the words. Like, as we, while we use Instagram, we all use Instagram over here, right? And we upload hashtags, different sorts of hashtags. Use hashtags while in a mind itself while thinking of an idea. Like, there is love, there's murder, hashtag murder in my mind, hashtag love. Combine all of them. Hashtag suspense. Even many of the people might think of writing a horror story. So think of horror, scare, panics, panic attacks. Think of these terms in mind. Connect the words. And when you start, just create a web of such kind of words in your mind and start connecting them. And that's how you will form an idea. Keep it informal and then make it crisp. That's how you will be able to, just develop it for yourself. Introducing characters is of great difficulty. How to? I'll come on to that. I'll definitely come on to that. Before that, once you have an idea for yourself, once you know that what is going to be the crux of your story, the base, one line base that defines the entire story, then you have to discover your dramatic element. Now, what are dramatic elements? For dramatic elements, it's like if I'm writing a love story, what will be the ups and lows in the entire story? What will be the cliffhanger? What can be the climax? What can be the anticlimax? Just think on those roughly. If you're able to do that, your story is half done. Trust me, your story is half done. It's just the polishing you need at the later stage of life. And to happen, bring all those elements in the one space, you need some great characters. The characters which will drive your story, the characters which will run your story, the characters which will make your story come into existence. So how do we get those characters? Just like Muskan has asked, how do we get those characters? The characters are one of the most, more than the idea, more than the crux of the story, it's the characters who play the big role. In my case, when in my book, The Meningus, I have many characters throughout the book. There are tons of characters. And there is a lead, there is an anti-lead, there is a supporting lead. So there are many of the characters. But at the when I hear people sharing their reviews on my book and when they talk to me, more than the story, they are like, how is this character like that? Why did you do that to this character? What is the main reason that this particular girl is like that? Why did she take revenge? Yeah, I did not even imagine that she would do that. So if you think, guys, that all of the reviews, even if you see any other big of the Shakespeare's books, people will talk about the Romeo and Juliet, how they were. They were the ones to drive that essence of the story. If Shakespeare might have written just a simple storyline, a guy and a girl, it would have not worked out. You need to build your characters so strong that the story itself goes along with it. How do you bring the characters? That is the question. Once you have the idea, once you have your elements, that what on the what basis are you going to pen the entire story down, you need to have a set of people you meet in your daily life, I would rather say. Just imagine, guys, that in my story, there are many people whose characteristics I have witnessed in people who are in touch with me. For example, the lead character, the way I see him in my book, the way I see him, his traits, his personality, I observed that somewhere. Few traits I observed while watching television in some of the other characters. Few of the traits I might have witnessed in one of my friends at work. Few of the traits I might have witnessed in any member of my family. Then I combined all of them and made that character. Character development is one of the most trickiest thing of the story because it can either make your story or break your story. Look around yourself while developing character. People you meet, the people you talk to with every day. See how, what are they doing? How are they doing? The way they talk. People say to me that I'm very scared of you because you're a writer and writers can do anything to make their stories come into life. It can, because most of the writers has to be very much observational. If you're observant, if you have that knack of observing things around it, panning, maybe even if you're writing one quote and you're writing one quote and you are just sharing it on your post or maybe in your stories, you will think that many people would be able to relate to it. Why? Why is that? Because you observe that, you experience that in your life and you share it out. Similarly, characters have to be the same. Something which you experience in your life. Something which you feel in the people around you. See, obviously, if you're writing a murder mystery, you will not meet a psychopath in your life. You will not meet a guy who has done tons of murders and you are just like, how will I get the traits of him? Read books. For that, you have to read books. If you're writing a love story, read tons of love stories before that. It can be to any other character. It can be written to an Indian author, can be relating to an international author. Read their books. Read how they have introduced their characters. Read the jargons they use. Read the words they use. Understand them. Understand their expressions. Understand how they are putting their characters, personality traits, their descriptions into an informal tale. How they're expressing that via dialogues. Before writing my book, I might have read around 10 to 50s of books. You need to do strong research for that. Three things make your character real strong: research, observation, and reading. Research, if I'm writing a murder mystery in case, if I'm writing a horror story, I'll definitely go and check websites that focuses on things which related to scary, panic attacks, just say, you know, लोग कहते हैं कि यहाँ सकते हैं भूत देखने वगैरह से. I will read things about that. I will read articles around that. I will even read, I will try to even listen to real documentaries that people might have. Why did this particular thing happen? Who was that guy who did a murder in the 1969? And he's been serving in jail since 70 years. Who is that person? You need to find that. You need to do your research. You need to read books relating to that genre. You need to observe people around you. And combine all of them. Mix those elements and form your character. Without that, it's really going to be a tough race for you. And many a time, it's not even I have been gone through that stage that people tend to write the name of the characters which they like. It's like मुझे एक कैरेक्टर का नाम बहुत पसंद है यार, जस्ट इन केस लाइक यार मुझे रोहन नाम बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है, क्या इसको मैं किताब में इसको, बट इज इट रेलेवेंट टू द स्टोरी, द नेम हैज टू इवन बी द रेलेवेंट ऑफ द स्टोरी. यार शिखा नाम बहुत अच्छा है, कैन आई पुट शिखा समवेयर, कैन शिखा बी द प्रोटैगनिस्ट गर्लफ्रेंड, मे बी शी कैन बी द प्रोटैगनिस्ट, बट व्हाई शिखा, हाउ डिड यू कम अप विद दैट नेम, डज हर ट्रेट्स रिसेंबल द नेम दैट यू आर गिवन टू हर. There is something I feel about reading patterns. I believe a lot of people prefer going to international authors in the country. That great question, Sakshi. Great one, because I believe Indian authors, if you're writing a story which is for the Indian audience, I would say. Unless you're writing something like Marvel. If you're writing something which is very Indian, like maybe Durjoy Dutta, maybe even Chetan Bhagat, or you know, Amish Tripathi, there are tons of great writers in the country. And even in a live session few weeks back when I was with SBI, and I told the same thing, that if an Indian author is writing a story which is really Indian, you should read Indian authors really very much. Because Indian authors know how to connect with the people. They get into the veins of their blood and find out the crux. I'm just giving an example of Chetan. You may think that he's a horrible writer. You may think that, oh, I don't like his stories much. But at the end of the day, his books still get sold. And that's just because he is able to relate with each and everyone. His language, his communication, the way he puts up the scenes is what each and every common Indian can relate to. So if you're writing a story which is like a long distance relationship about a guy who is in Kashmir and a girl who is in Kanyakumari, you have to stick to the Indian audience. You have to stick to the essence of the story. It can be relating to the scenes going at India-Pakistan's borders in Jammu Kashmir. Things that the journey between the quarrel of the parents, the caste, the creed, how those problems come, how will they overcome? Will something tragic happen in the end? It has to be real Indian. That's how you will be able to do. If I'm just imagine, guys, if I'm writing a story like a girl about a girl and a guy who's a tremendous big love story and they get divorced at a certain point of time, people will not be able to accept that in India, especially because that's a Western culture. Just putting an example, it can be very subjective, it's a Western element. If I'm writing a story and it's a beautiful love story and there are certain problems that come up after the wedding and both the husband and the wife, you know, they make an effort to solve it out. Regardless the outcome, it can be bad, it can be good. So that's how an Indian story can be, you know. Protagonists of love stories are never the lovers itself. It's always someone else other than them. And there I do develop creation of character. That's really true, Muskan. Because see, love stories are totally different genre. You can't say that there is just one protagonist in the story. Because in every love story, there are at least 3 to 4 protagonists. 2 of the main, of course. And the others are the ones who fuel them. And they should be equally called as the protagonist. Every creation of the character is your mind's game. It's your mind. If I make a character today and it's like I make it feel like it's the protagonist of the story, but at the end I want people to change that ideology. Oh shit, I was thinking he's the protagonist, but at the end of the story I'm like, oh no, ye to kuch aur hi kya soch rahi thi aur kya nahi. So that is also one of the key aspects, Muskan, which you can really think. And most of the love stories happen come with that. But these days I'm reading a few Indian authors' mythological stories as well, because my storyline, my book, is into that series. So this has even started to happen in other genres as well. Publishing and advertising is not at all tough. Let me tell you, it's not at all tough, because Sakshi, nowadays, with the help of tech, with the help of social media, the world has come at one place. Even just look at the SPA over here. It's a great publication. You can just reach out to them. You can share your manuscript. Then they can review it back for you. So it's one. And once you do that, there you have to stand down, guys. Advertising is important. I will not say it is not. Advertising is really important. But best marketing for any book is to be the word of mouth, to be the evangelism. What is evangelism? Evangelism is when the book does great without even letting it do great. It's the story, it's the people who read your book drive your story. And 99.9% of the times happen that. Guys, rarely there would be time where you will think that, oh, this book has come on Amazon, let me read it. You will think, you will be like, okay, I'll give it a thought, but not sure. And dusri jagah agar kisi friend ne aapse kaha ki yaar ye book padh bahut achhi hai, iski storyline to kafi relate kar payega ya kar payega, immediately within a second of your mind you will be like, I should buy this. My friend has recommended me, my cousin, my brother, any of people has recommended me, I should buy that. Most of the books get sold by this aspect, by evangelism. And to build that evangelism, you need to make your story strong. You need to build, just tell your friends and family to read your books. Tell them to buy it. Tell them to recommend it to their friends. Slowly and steadily, that is how this chain will become. More people will try to get to read the book. The problem is, in this last 2-3 years, the world has become very commercial. Something or the other is evolving every year. And now I can see a lot of authors are doing book trailers. They are doing, you know, they are getting celebrities on board to feature them as the, just imagine, like, I was reading that, I saw Amish book's trailer about Sita, and it was really great. But that could happen only when he reached that point. His first book, no one knows. He did not market his first book. He just wrote and got published. People started reading it, grabbing a copy, and see where he is now. So even if you case, guys, if you're writing a book, and just let it work on its own. Tell your friends, tell your family, recommend it to every person you meet in your life. Bring the chain into existence. Those 5 people will tell to other 50 people. Those 50 people will tell to 100 people. 100 to 500, thousands. That's how the chain. It's very tough. You might have think that it's very easy to say. But I know it's very tough, but that's the start. I mean, Chetan Bhagat, when he wrote his initial books like 5 Point Someone and 3 Mistakes of My Life, he did not market it. आई कुड रियली सी एनी एडवर्टाइजमेंट ऑन, तब तो सोशल मीडिया था भी नहीं, तो लोग जानते नहीं, ई कॉमर्स उतना नहीं था, फिर भी बुक डिड वेरी वेल बिकॉज पीपल अप्रिशिएटेड दैट, पीपल इन हिज अराउंड हिज विसिनिटी इन हिज एरिया रेड रिकमेंडेड द बुक एंड दैट्स हाउ ही बिकेम व्हाट ही इज टुडे. इवन फॉर माई सेल्फ, माई बुक जस्ट गॉट लॉन्च्ड, आई एम डूइंग यू नो getting my friends, my people read it. I'm every day I text them that, guys, what did you like about the story? What is this? What did you dislike? What is the pro and con according to you? What do you think? Will you be able to tell this to your friends and family to read it out? What will be the chances that they will read it? So these are the things which you need to idealize in the first place after, you know, penning your story and getting it published. What do you think about anthologies? Should I participate in one? Please do that. Anthologies, I believe, are the stepping stones of, you know, penning a book. Because mine myself started in participating into different anthologies. बहुत सारे anthologies थी, SPS से कुछ थी, and one of my friends wrote a few independently, and he was like, co-author this with me. So I was part of a very good anthologies, thanks to SPOE. Because when you write in anthologies, you write short stories, you write scribbles, which is a starting point. If you can write a short story about 2-3 pages, which has an intense, good story according to you, trust me, guys, if you're able to do that, you will be able to definitely pen a big book, 250 page book, or maybe 400. FC. The journey of long success, a journey of big growth starts with a single small step. An anthology can be that one to you. That's how you will practice on writing stories. Become a compiler by yourself. Become a writer by yourself in those stories. And just see how it works. Make people read your short stories in those anthologies. See what do they react. See if they like their short stories or not. And that's how you will go along. That's how you will go. Every mountain was just a small land before, with rain, with other things coming around, sand, stones started to pile up and hence it became a big mountain. Earlier it was not. So that's why you need to compile things around. That's how you know you start building your writing base. I remember I wrote around 15 to 20 short stories before writing this big one, and those short stories were something which I related in my life, which was very real, or लोग काफी relate करते थे उस चीज़ से. तो मैंने जब लोगों से सुना, उनसे उनके reviews लिए, मैंने उनका anthology में पढ़ाई कि anthology पढ़ना मेरी, इसमें मैंने short story लिखी थी. How is it? Tell me now. Do you think it's relatable? Do you think that it's emotional? I remember I wrote a one bad incident which happened in my life. I penned it into words by using the example of a story, and a fictional story. I converted that experience into a fictional story, and I could see the people who were in touch with me reading that story and having tears in their eyes. So, जब ऐसी चीजें आपको दिखती हैं ना, that motivates you can if you can do this, बड़ी story कर सकते हो. कोई task नहीं. You just need your heart's call. You just need to listen to your fingers. If your fingers are tempting to write one. Your fingers are itching that, oh no, I have to grab a pen and pen a story. Go for it. Just go for it. And stories, but the big difference between a short story and a long story, guys, way key hai, that short story comes with one plot, and the big story, the novel, comes with multiple plots. Just imagine, guys, if you have the idea in your mind, if you have come up with the climax of your story, if you have come up with the characters of your story, and you have the basic plot, but how will you keep the plot running? You can't run a 300 page book on just one big plot. Of course, it is the base, but at the end of the day, if a reader like me, if I'm just reading a book which just focuses on one single plot, I will not be excited to read it further. You need to build subplots at times. Subplots play a big, big role. And how do you come up with such plots? You have developed, you have the idea, you have the crux of your story, you have the characters right now. Just think of the story of the character individually. If there are five characters in my story, maybe possibly if I can name it as Rohan, Shikha, Priya, or anyone. Priya has her own life, different story. Something is going in her own life. Shikha has something going in her life. Rohan has something going in his life. And all three of them are connected to each other for some big one plot. But something or the other is happening in their individual lives as well. So when you write a big plot, think about the characters, their storylines. If see, in case my lead, the lead in my book, she, the girl of Stonehenge, came to take revenge and everything. So it's just not the story about her. It is just, I have also penned a story about the guy who has problems going on in his life, in his professional life. The girl has got some brutal past. The girl's family was done something really heinous acts, and each the guy had some great friends. The story of those friends, how does it come out? So it's just your subplots will depend on the type of stories you create, individual stories you create for your characters, and how you join them. As I said, story, a big story or a small story, it's nothing but just connecting the dots. First, you connect the dots in your mind about the idea. Then you do the same way by connecting research, observation, and a storyline by connecting those dots over there. How do you match the three? And now with the plots. Have to connect the stories of the characters individually and what connects them to one big plot. That's how will you will be able to write effective scenes, guys. Scenes mainly depend on the type of sub story the characters have. If I'm writing an autobiography of mine, and I will write my story in that. For sure, I will. It's because it's an autobiography. It should revolve around me. I'm writing my story entirely, but I will be also writing the story of the people I meet. Possibly of my girlfriend, how was she? What happened in her life? How what role did I play in that? So that's how your story should develop. You need to connect the individual stories of the characters to the main story, to the main idea, to the crux. That's how you will be able to divide it into subplots, and those subplots will help you create effective scenes. I see a lot of comments here. How do you use a proto writer on the question which arises me more of, but I wish topic always comes from within. Don't listen to your heart. Honestly, guys, if you forced your heart that I want to write a story, and if it tells you, don't listen. If it tells you when you don't force it, that's when you're found a story. It can come randomly. Don't stress yourself. Just imagine if you're watching television, if you're watching some movie on Amazon or Netflix, if you're just watching some television news, if you're listening to music, but randomly, if you're doing your assignments, because I believe you might have you might be all students possibly. So even if you're doing an assignment करते करते यार एक चीज दिमाग में स्ट्राइक हो गई, लिख लो तो क्या आई थी वो, क्या वो स्टोरी था? बिकॉज द मोर यू स्ट्रेस कि मुझे स्टोरी लिखनी है, उतना नहीं होगा. आई हैव गॉन थ्रू दैट फ्रस्ट्रेशन. आई हैव रियलाइज्ड दैट व्हेन एवर आई फोर्स्ड माइसेल्फ टू राइट, नो विजिट, आई हैव टू राइट, विजिट, यू हैव टू राइट, यू हैव टू कंप्लीट द स्टोरी बाय दिस डेट, यू हैव टू प्लान इट. ट्रस्ट मी गाइस, आई वाज नेवर एबल टू दैट. आई डिड व्हेन माय हार्ट वाज रेडी. कहते हैं ना, माय मॉम हमेशा, माय मॉम यू से दिस थिंग टू मी एवरी डे, कोई भी काम करो ना, मन हो तो ही करना, नहीं तो जबरदस्ती मत करो, काम बिगड़ जाएगा. और ये सेम चीज बुक लिखने का टाइम हमेशा होती है. करो तो मन से करो, जबरदस्ती करने जाओगे स्टोरी खराब होगी, कैरेक्टर्स खराब हो जाएंगे, और देन फ्रस्ट्रेशन आएगा, विच इज रियली नॉट गुड. But it's a part and parcel of a writing journey, but try avoiding as much as you can. You've seen many authors writing short stories, but not being able to publish successful novels. How does an amateur writer need a start? I mean, guys, writing is quite competition. Obviously, like, you want to be the bestseller. That's something which you want your sales to be like that. You want your sales record to become like that. But writing को कभी competition की तरफ से मत देखो. लिख रहे हो तो खुद के लिए लिखो और खुद और लोगों को सुनाओ कि तुमने क्या लिखा है. अगर तुम कंपटीशन के नजरिए से देखने जाओ कि यार मुझे यार if I today if I am writing into I am into mythological stories, I've written a murder mystery right now and I'm like oh guy I've written a murder mystery और अभी मैंने mythology भी लिखी है थोड़ी बहुत, क्या मैं अमिश के साथ कंपटीशन में आ सकता हूँ? I want to become better than Amish, I want to become better than Devdutt Patnaik. Can it happen? No. Every writer has a different style of writing. Amish has different, Devdutt has different, I have different. And it's not about competition, it's about how you write good stories. Good stories will always drive you sales. Good stories will always help in getting people to read your books. And when it comes to amateurs not being able to write successful novels, it's the lack of experience. See, if I've written a book right now, The Benign Hiss is there, and if people come to me and say that, Vijit, I did not like this particular thing in your book, you have to work on that. Or maybe, Vijit, this is one thing which triggers people negatively. I will note it down. And if I'm writing another book, I'll be like, oh, last time I received these reviews, I need to work on. You can't be 100% perfect. No human in the world is guys 100% perfect in terms of writing any story. Some or the other way, there will be critics, there will be flaws. It's the art of perception. Many people think that, let me give you guys an interesting example for that. Thanks Akshay for coming, taking this up, but there are two perspectives to Ramayana. Many people think, most of 99% of the people feel that Ramayana happened because Sita got kidnapped by Ravan and Ram had to rescue her. This was the storyline. And his journey for the savior of hers, his journey on how did he overcome demons and all, was one aspect. The other side of the story, Ravan, why did he do that? People rarely ask this question, why did Ravana, he kidnapped Sita? Ravana did that just because to avenge the disrespect, the act which happened with his sister. So, one person of the people might think that way. A girl, you know, there was a small story which I read, that a girl, his mother asked her child, daughter, what type of brother do you want? If in case, because the mother was pregnant and she was expecting a baby. And she asked her daughter that, if you have a brother, how do you want he to be? The girl was like, I want a brother like Ravan, who avenged a big war, who sacrificed his life for his own sister. So there are two angles to the story. Which do you choose defines the entire storyline. And if you're unable to adapt that, if you're unable to relate to the people, see, I will write a story for the 99% of the people with 1% of effect on it. Because 99% logo ko wo cheez padhna zyada pasand hai, wo stories unko relatable zyada achhi lagti hai, 1% walon ko nahi lagti. Agar main 99% wali cheez likhunga jo logo ko pasand hai padhne aur usme main khali ek effect dal dunga us 1% ka, to shayad wo zyada kaam karegi. So you need to adapt those things. And that's why I think many amateur writers, even I'll include myself into that, because even though if I'll get my 5 books published, 10 books published in the future, I'll call myself an amateur because I'll be ever learning. Writing is an ever learning stage. So it has to happen at every point of time. Sometimes I wonder if Chetan Bhagat is good luck. Not exactly, but you can call it that way. If you can see, I really like his story of two states, three mistakes of life. But the story is he has spent well, for quite good, you know. Yeah, a few of them, barring a few, which people might not be able to accept it, but if he has reached that stage, that means he has written at least some of the good content in his life. I have started only, but my fans think I'm an underrated struggling author, you know. So I wanted to put this across. Every writer is a struggling writer, guys. Her writer is a struggler. वो स्ट्रगल करता ही है. आज तक मैंने किसी राइटर को ये कहते हुए नहीं सुना कि आज मैंने एक बहुत बड़ा एस्टैब्लिश राइटर हूँ. इवन आई वाज लिसनिंग टू देवदत्त पटनायक इंटरव्यू, ही सेड दैट आई डोंट राइट जस्ट लाइक दैट, आई हैव टू डू अ लॉट ऑफ रिसर्च, आई हैव टू सॉल्व टू यूज दैट व्हाट आई हैव माय माइंड टू राइट सम गुड स्टोरीज एंड आई नीड टू डू ग्रेट इंडियन आर्कियोलॉजी रिसर्च हाउ टू राइट माइथोलॉजी स्टोरीज. सो every writer is a struggler. They struggle to find information, they struggle to find elements, and it has to be the future like that, otherwise you will not be able to do it. Even myself, even 10 years down the line, when I'll be having my the Benanga series published along, I will still call myself as a struggling writer. So writing is something, I guess, guys, you should do it more for yourself, because it is your creation. Wo कैरेक्टर, वो कहानी, वो आपका क्रिएशन है. चाहे लोग कुछ भी कहे, वो आपके लिए है, वो आपकी बनाई हुई चीज है. सो इट विल ऑलवेज रिमेन क्लोज टू यू रिगार्डलेस, नो मैटर वेर यू गो, हाउ मच यू ग्रो. सो इट्स योर क्रिएशन एंड यू ऑलवेज नीड टू स्टिक टू दैट एस्पेक्ट. आफ्टर डूइंग 7 Sorry for that, guys. When I penned the story, na guys, so I had a love story pen ki thi bahut pehle, around 3-4 years back. Mujhe idea bhi nahi hai maine kitne kagaz waste kiye us dauran. In down those months, I wasted paper like what, and I regret that today. But it's fine, like it's part and parcel of every writer's journey. But it happens. You just need to focus. You just need to believe in yourself that yes, you can write a good, if you can write short stories, if you can participate in anthologies, definitely, yeah, you are made for a big novel. You are definitely made for a big novel, because big novels come with tons. See, how is a novel made? So guys, so let me tell you, how is a novel made? A novel is a collection of small stories connecting into big major ones, just like I said earlier. Write tons of small stories connecting to the same plot, join them, and that's how your story will form. That's the literal meaning of a novel, which you can find in Oxford or anywhere else. It's a connection of small stories which relate into a big one in the future. After doing some turntables, I'm stuck. Compiling anthology before that. When I was submitting my work, I didn't know much about it. It's a waste of time. Anthologies is never a waste of time. It's, I would say, it's your starting step. Well, because that's how you will feel the sense of when you have the book in your hand, guys. So, if your anthology, if there are many writers who have written something, and that kitab will come to your hands, and you will write your own story, poem, something. If you read that, and if you find your name in there in a book, you will feel proud for yourself. You will show that to your parents, in your family. They will feel proud for you. Just imagine, guys, ki that proud moment for your own self, if you're having by just that small story in the book, how big it will be when you have it for the entire book. Get that motivation, guys. Wo ek spark hai. Wo ek chota spark agar aa gaya na dil mein, it can turn into flame any moment, any time, anywhere. You just need that one small spark of that belief in yourself, of that proud in yourself that yes, I'm made for this. I want to see myself on the cover page, a novel by whatever your name is, like a novel by Prakriti Patel, a novel by Rupal Arora. You know, that's the future you want to see yourself for yourself. It, your book is your baby, and you have to definitely go according to that. rest it will not happen. एंड एक बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट चीज होती है गाइस बुक राइटिंग में विच मेनी पीपल इग्नोर इट. अरे काफी मुझे राइटर्स मिले जिन्होंने वेब नॉवेल्स लिखने स्टार्ट करी थी और मुझे चैप्टर्स भेजते थे कि प्लीज बताओ मुझे कैसा है, हाउ इज दिस थिंग. एंड व्हेन आई टू रीड दैट आई कुड नॉट फिगर आउट कि ये बंदा प्रेजेंट में लिख रहा है, पास्ट में लिख रहा है, फ्यूचर में लिख रहा है, कुछ समझ नहीं आ रहा है क्योंकि तीनों के एलिमेंट्स मिक्स दिख रहे हैं. So you need to understand that if I'm writing a story, it is happening presently, so I need to correct my tense. Just for an example, Ramesh's heart was broken like a soul. And due to that, he took a dip into the Arabian Sea and never got out. So this is something which I written in a past way. In the same way, like Ramesh is going through a bad phase in his life and that's why he's going to take a dip at Arabian Sea and probably he will not come out. So this is how I write present future tense. Grammar has to be the thing here, guys. Agar aap aisa likhoge ki Ramesh was broken and hurt and he's going to take a dip in the Arabian Sea, it's not relating. It's not relating. Either he was, either he got, or either he would. You need to connect the identify the whether you're going to write the story in past, whether you're using present tense. If you're using all three of them, how will you connect it? If there is a flashback in the story, what type of flashback is it? Is it coming in the start? Is it coming in the middle? How will I define to the people that maybe my flashback aa raha hai to main past tense mein ja rahi hu, book future tense mein chal rahi hai, present mein chal rahi hai, lekin ab main ja rahi hu past mein. You have to mention that aspect. Agar wo nahi aata hai, then people will not be able to get it. In the dry run of my book, guys, जब मेरी बुक का ड्राई रन चला था, मैं रिव्यूज ले रहा था पब्लिशरों से, बड़े लोगों से, मुझे दो तीन फीडबैक मिले. If you have done this dialogue, but whose perspective was it? And was it past? Was it present? I could not get it. क्या चीज़? That triggered me. I was like, shit, this is a big thing. Okay, that was one of the major dialogues of my book. It was a flashback, one of the page ones. And if people are not able to get it, why will people will be get the storyline? How will they get the story? Unko essence milega hi nahi. You need to see what kind of tense are you using, what kind of viewpoint. Third person se likh rahe ho, second person se likh rahe ho, first person. So what is first person, second person and third person? First person storyline is when you write from your point of view. Like you think yourself, like I've introduced a character named give me a name, guys, in the comment. Give me any name. I could not think of any. If you can help me with a name, you can say that in the comments. Any two names or any one name, guys. कोई भी एक नाम दे दो. That will make me feel that, oh guys, you are there and you have not lost. Oh, I get that. So Soumya has said Pallavi. That's a good name. So if I'm writing a story in a first person. With Pallavi's perspective, my storyline will be entirely that I am doing this. I was going to take a bath, but suddenly a guy came into my house and he killed me. And he tried to kill me. So you're writing from Pallavi's perspective. You are being in her shoes. You are being in a body as a writer. You're writing the entire story. Third person is when Pallavi was going to take a shower. Suddenly a guy broke into the house and tried to kill her. This is when you're narrating from a narrator's point of view. You're using names of the characters. You're the witness of the story. And the second person is rare chance that it happens. Second person is when it's usually, most of the time it happens in love stories, that there are multi-death that happens from the girl's side, the guy's side, and the story goes along. Pallavi's boyfriend or Pallavi's husband or maybe anything else. Or it can be even thanks to the LGBTQ community, even the same sex stories are doing great, guys, these days. If you want to think on that aspect, storyline on the LGBTQ lines, it will swell, it will sell. People will love to read, but it should be relating to the book. So your tense, your point of view will definitely work. And most of the times, 60% of the times, people either write in third person view or first person view, because readers are able to accept it well. Second person view is kind of complicated because there are rush of scenes, rush of characters, quick switches, which people are very tough to get. But if you are good at that, please do it. Or else, many of the times, one can prefer taking first person or maybe a third person. Given a choice to you guys, if you want to write something really great about a character, you have to just feel him through the entire book, go for the first person. If you feel that other characters are equally important throughout the story, you need to mention them as well, go for the third person. Develop your story like that. And hence, sooner or later, it will make your dream come true of getting your book published. So, is there any more questions, guys? Like, I don't see, I'm feeling like, everyone is lost in some or the other way. It might be raining and all. Are you guys there or you just. How do you write multiple POV novels? Multiple POV is the another word for third person perspective. Third person perspective is where you write point of views of different characters. My book, The Benign Hiss, is a third person novel. I have written that in a third person point of view, where each I have focused on each and every character individually. If I'm the lead, the protagonist is no doubt there is one guy named Abhimanyu in my book. He's the protagonist. But regardless that, there are some other characters which I have to focus. If there's a politician in my book, I will do his story as well. I have to take his perspective for that time being. And for that to happen, you need to learn to get switches. Give equal amount of time to each and every character in the story. Probably for the protagonist, you have to spend some more time on that. But if you want to write multiple point of views, it's great. It's a must element for third person perspective story writers. Just focus on each other character when the time is required. If I'm writing a particular scene where a storyline where I see there is murder, there is a crime happening in the house, I will first write on the protagonist who is inside the house, how he is feeling. And post his feelings, I might write about the criminal who broke in. And that's how you do multiple point of views. And then I can might show what the neighbor is saying outside. The two guys in the house, the one who is resides in a criminal broken. I will even write his perspective, the neighbor. What is he feeling about that? Will he call the police? Will he tell someone else around the vicinity? That's how you write multiple point of views. You have to go step by step to each and every character, depending on its importance and essential. Sheetal once, what is the name of your novel? The name of my novel, Sheetal, is The Benign Hiss. It's a mixed element of each and every genre. I know it's, you will find out, it's a khichdi. No, it's not a khichdi, guys. It's majorly a murder mystery, which has the essence of thriller, suspense, mythology, interestingly, and even love. So, if you're writing such kind of story, which has multiple elements of emotions, of feels, you need your head to work along with your heart. That's how it's going to happen. And when you want your head to work, you need to listen to your heart about the storyline, about the idea which it gives. Think of stories like which people would like to read. Just imagine if you have been writing love stories since time, short stories maybe, and slowly and steadily you come at a stage where people are like, you write such great small short and small stories. Will you ever write something else? Like you will write love, but will you try a thriller? So not that will become a challenge for you. And when you write a thriller after being writing a love one, you will be like, oh, I was pretty good at it. Now, if I've written a thriller story, now I've written a love story, how can I submerge this both of them together? Practice. So that's right. Practice in every genre. Like that's how you will be able to explore yourself. Try writing a thriller story. Try writing a love, try writing a suspense. Even scary, even if you have interest in horror, go for that. And see which is that story which works very well. And if every story is working out good for you, try to connect some all of them into one big story and see what would be the responses of the people. See how will you feel for yourself when you will be able to write such one big story of such interesting elements. What do you think about Wattpad? I have a plan of improving my writing in my my Wattpad. See, there are touching, and there is not only Wattpad, guys. Wattpad is surely one of the ways of, you know, reaching out to people. There are multiple writing platforms on Instagram where you can submit your write-ups and get your picture there. Then, so don't worry, guys. COVID nahi hai. It's just the monsoon which is hitting me badly right now. There is Your Quote. There is many other platforms where people share themselves. Even you can start writing blogs. My writing journey, guys, started with a blog. It was in 2014 or 13 maybe when I started writing, and I posted my first blog on WordPress. I still remember, and I sustained my WordPress blog for at least 3-4 years. I kept writing articles, short stories, motivational posts, even I tried writing song lyrics, tried that. So I was doing very well on WordPress. I connected with fellow bloggers. I used to get their reviews. पहले आई यूज्ड टू गेट लाइक 10-15 व्यूज आते थे महीने में. जैसे मेरे 2-3 साल हो गए, आई वाज लाइक गेटिंग अराउंड 500 टू 1000 व्यूज पर मंथ ऑन वर्डप्रेस. सो दैट्स हाउ वन जर्नी गोस. इवन इफ यू आर ऑन वाटरपैड, इफ यू आर ट्राइंग टू इंप्रूव योर राइटिंग ओवर देयर, बी देयर, सस्टेन योरसेल्फ, सस्टेन योर राइटिंग स्किल्स, कीप ग्रोइंग, लेट द अदर पीपल इन दैट कम्युनिटी रीड योर वर्ड्स, शेयर इट आउट, लिसन टू देम, कनेक्ट विद देम, शेयर योर व्यूज ऑन देयर राइटिंग्स. And that's how you will be able, you know, to recognize yourself in the mirror where you stand in the world of stories and writing. You will be able to see that if you are here and if you want to be here, what is the path? And if you are here, you want to maintain that, how will you do that? So these are the platforms you can try out for WordPress again. Wattpad is a good one. SPI is where you can publish your writings. There is Blogger, Google's blogging website, where if you want to write long articles or stories, go for that. Let the world read it. Because if I'm writing a story and I keep it to myself, I will find it great. But if I write a story on a public platform and people around the world are reading it, I will get mixed reviews. Some might appreciate it, some might not. Some might like something, some will not. So Wattpad and all are definitely worth to try on. Go feature your writings on SPS page on Instagram. Let the people comment. See how do they react to it. You might receive DMs of people who, I really found this code very relatable, which you posted. That's great, no? If people are finding relatable, you know what your strength is. And if people text you that, oh, I don't agree with this, that becomes subjective. And it's like, it's fine if you are not able to agree with that, but majority of people might, and if most of the people are not, then there's something wrong with you. Then there's something which you need to find yourself in the world of writing. But at the end of the day, listen to the core strength of your heart and go for it. Otherwise, no. Good to know you're safe from COVID. I recovered, yeah. Even I took my, I got my vaccine for sure, so feeling relief because of that. And once you're writing a story, guys, learn to build cliffhangers. Because cliffhangers are one of the biggest things which will drive people to read your entire book. Try putting a cliffhanger at the end of each and every chapter. So what are cliffhangers first? Cliffhangers are that point of a story, that points in the story which people should know about it. Like they are so excited that it leaves people on an unmanned road where they don't know what will happen next. Like in my book, in the case of the book, when people read it, they were like, I'm not just, babbling about myself, about my book. It's just personal experience which I'm sharing with you guys. When people read my book, and they told me that, Vijit, I read the entire book in one day. I was like, how did you make it? And people were like, every chapter had a connection with the other. And it lived on a certain note, which made me read to the next. मुझे वो आंसर चाहिए था. फर्स्ट कैंडी में जो क्वेश्चन थे, आई एंडेड द चैप्टर एंड हैड टू फाइंड दैट आंसर. एंड एवरी चैप्टर हैड सम और द अदर कनेक्शन. इफ यू आर राइटिंग अ स्टोरी गाइस, कैरेक्टर्स हैं माइंड में, सब कुछ सॉर्टेड है. विदो यू हैव अ ग्रेट कैरेक्टर, यू हैव अ ग्रेट स्टोरी, नाउ हैव द एलिमेंट्स, यू हैव द टेंस, यू हैव द पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. ट्राई टू बिल्ड सस्पेंस. इन अ केस, इन अ लव स्टोरी, the guy is from Mumbai, the girl lives in London, and the first chapter just the intro of the guy, but at the end you mention something like he wishes to proceed great in his life, but the problem in his family will never let him do that. If you just end up with this line, you will want to read the second chapter. What problem was he talking before? कौन से प्रॉब्लम उसकी फैमिली में कि उसको आगे नहीं बढ़ने दे रही, क्या चीज आगे. तो ऐसी छोटी छोटी चीजें है ना, ये स्टोरी का हाइप बढ़ता है. आइडियली हाउ मेनी ड्रॉप्स यू शुड यू वन हैव टू गो सी. ड्राफ्ट जैसा सिस्टम ना, आई डोंट बिलीव मच, बट ऑब्वियसली पहला ड्राफ्ट तो कभी नहीं होना चाहिए, क्योंकि इट्स जस्ट स्क्रैच. यू नीड टू पॉलिश योर मैन्युस्क्रिप्ट थाउजेंड्स ऑफ टाइम्स. क्योंकि मैंने जब अपनी मैन्युस्क्रिप्ट पॉलिश की थी, काफी चीजें मुझे कट करनी पड़ी थी. मुझे लगा था कि यार, बिकॉज आई हैड अ मैथोलॉजिकल एलिमेंट इन द बुक, सो आई वाज लाइक दिस माइट हर्ट द सेंटिमेंट्स ऑफ पीपल. सो इन द थर्ड ड्राफ्ट आई हैड टू डिलीट दैट, क्योंकि बीइंग द फर्स्ट बुक आई डिड नॉट वॉन्ट रीडर्स टू फील ह्यूमिलिएटेड, और यू नो उनको लगे ये चीज तो इनटॉलरेबल है, ये चीज होनी नहीं चाहिए किताब. तो काफी बार देर आर सर्टन थिंग्स विच यू नीड टू कीप इन माइंड दैट पहली बार जो आता है लिखना, डोंट रेस्ट्रिक्ट योर सेल्फ टू राइट इन द फर्स्ट ड्राफ्ट. फर्स्ट ड्राफ्ट इज जस्ट नथिंग बट अ खिचड़ी दैट यू क्रिएट, कुछ नहीं. वो एक वो खिचड़ी है जिसको यू हैव टू मेक अ बिरयानी आउट ऑफ इट, एंड वो एक प्रोसेस से होता है, वो मल्टीपल स्टेजेस से होता है. मैनी डू इट इन द सेकेंड ड्राफ्ट, मैनी डू इट इन द थर्ड, एंड मैनी आर एबल टू डू इट इन द फिफ्थ. कोई तो एक ड्राफ्ट में कर लेते हैं, लेकिन आई डोंट थिंक ऐसा कोई महान अभी तक आया है जिससे पहले ड्राफ्ट में किया होगा तो is no more, is not less than any god, but completely depends on the effort one makes to, you know, work on the storyline, on the characters. The average amount is 3 to 4, I would say, but it depends on your type of writing skills. It surely does that. Is there anything else, guys, like if you want to ask something, or you know, throw any question around. राइटिंग इज लाइक बहुत सिंपल जर्नी होती है गाइस, कि आपको लगता है कि ये स्टोरी लिख ली बस काफी है, कॉम्प्लिकेट हो जाएगी चीज है, बट नहीं होता है. इट डजेंट हैपन. यू जस्ट नीड टू फोकस ऑन योर स्ट्रेंथ्स. यू जस्ट नीड टू थिंक दैट यस, आई कैन डू इट. This is no less than a barrier for me. And think of the characters. Live with those characters, guys. I will say this to every time, regardless whatever the content you make on, regardless anything, like I would say, the suspense you create, it's your characters which drive your story again. So I will give you an example. I'm giving an example of a movie right now, guys. Movie ka example de raha hu. Andhadhun. Many of you might have watched it, but it was a great movie, great content. But it was the individual stories of Radhika and Ayushman that just smooth, that made the pave so smooth that the content did its job automatically. For Ayushman, his story of why he chose to be blind. For Radhika, why she used to work there. For Tabu, why did she do that murder? The way the characters express themselves, the emotions that they brought inside the content, broke the story entirely. So that's how you have to build your characters strong. If your characters are strong, story will automatically, अगर तुम्हारा स्टोरी यहाँ है और तुम्हारे कैरेक्टर तुम्हें यहाँ बनाए ना, स्टोरी उसके ऊपर चली जाएगी विदाउट अ डाउट. Have you written anything on your own life experience? Yes, I have. So I'll give you an interesting example that I wrote on an experience which I faced in my life. It was a personal loss to me. I lost a part of my life, which was very close to me. So it was one of the worst incidents of my life, which I'll never be able to forget. It's the missing, it's the void that I can never feel that. No one can ever feel that. So I penned a story regarding that experience. वो एक छोटा सा एक्सपीरियंस था, वॉइड था मेरे हार्ट में, उसको मैंने कृष्ण द स्टोरी के थ्रू बता दिया. एंड आई जस्ट चोज द कैरेक्टर, आई जस्ट चोज द कंटेंट, द वे द मैसेज हैज टू बी ड्रिवन. एंड वो एक कैंथो में भी आ चुका था, एसपीआई की एक कैंथो थी, स्क्रिबल्स विद इमोशंस. सो आई थिंक आई पब्लिश माई दैट शॉर्ट स्टोरी इन दैट बुक. It was my personal life experience which I shared, and if you can visit my blogs, most of my blogs have my life experiences only. Whether it's a short story or maybe it's an article, it's something which I've experienced at certain point of stage. Because when you put experience to any story, it's like an icing on the cake. It's like an icing on the cake. You make it feel much more realistic than it could ever be. So experience always plays a big role. Whatever you do that, you know, it can be a smallest thing. It can be just like if you're visiting to a general store in your nearby area to buy milk. How the shopkeeper behaves is an experience to you. You can use that in your storyline at some point of the stage. So, as I say, observations, life experiences fuel your story to a greater extent. Priyoshik, you has asked, anything on writing blocks after writing few chapters? Many times. Writing blocks comes at me. See, if you know that what kind of story you're writing, how concept chapter mein kya hone wala hai, kaun se scene mein kya hoga, so writing block this cheez is very tough to get. But if you're writing a story, if you just have the concept, if see the way which I wrote that, I just had the concept, I just had that one idea, aur main likhte gaya. But काफी बार ये हुआ कि in case that I reach a certain point of chapters and I'm now I'm like अब क्या करूं, अभी I'm not getting a lead, ये चीज तो मैंने लिख दी, do I need to change that thing, do I need to change the entire structure over here? So think on that, it will happen. You have to think, you have to give yourself some time, you need to find your way. I still remember I started writing the story before lockdown, मतलब Jan Feb December में. और दिसंबर इज वेयर आई गॉट द बर्थ ऑफ राइटिंग द बनाई दिस. और इन मंथ ऑफ मार्च एंड अप्रैल तक मेरे आई वाज हैविंग अ राइटर्स ब्लॉक. मुझे नहीं समझ रहा कि आप मैं स्टोरी को आगे कैसे बढ़ाऊं. एंड सरप्राइजिंगली महाभारत रामायण यूज्ड टू वेयर दैट टाइम. एंड आई रिमेम्बर एवरी फैमिली इन द कंट्री, मोस्ट ऑफ देम वर स्टेकिंग टू जस्ट इन लिविंग रूम एंड वॉचिंग दैट. सो डिड आई डू दैट, आई हैड द सेम फील्स एंड आई वाज लाइक this is the element which I can add, this is the biggest thing which is missing in my book. So many a times you need to wait for certain things to arrive on its own and just go with it, because stress karoge as I said nahi milega. Wait karo, keep your mind and heart calm, things will come automatically to you. Just give some space to your writing, just give some space to your stories, and eventually it will happen on its own without a doubt. Have you done any kind of this? No, never. Honestly, my English have been, it's, you'll laugh, guys. I was able to build my language by watching English movies, by reading books, and by watching English sports. Nothing else. This is how I built my language. I have never done any writing course. I have never done any speaking course. It's just the experience. It's just the kind of enthusiasm I've always had for watching Hollywood movies, or maybe into reading, which made me feel like, oh, even I can learn that, I can write. So it's nothing like language. See, if you don't have a strong command in the language of English and writing in your own words, koi baat nahi, likh do. Pehla draft hai na, dusre draft mein, tisre draft mein, polish hota jayega. You will be taking the help of people around you who are good in English. You can ask them for suggestions. And that's how one builds themselves. With small stones. No one is perfect. Koi perfect nahi, main bhi nahi hu. एंड लेट मी टेल यू गाइस, तुम लोग राइटर्स हो, हम सब राइटर्स हैं, कोई एडिटर नहीं. देयर इज अ बिग डिफरेंस बिटवीन अ राइटर एंड एन एडिटर. अ राइटर कैन प्रोबब्ली नॉट बी एज गुड एज इट कैन बी, ही कैन बी इन योर ग्रामर, यू नॉट कैन नॉट बी श्योर. ही राइट्स इमोशंस, ही राइट्स स्टोरीज, ही डज नॉट करेक्ट हिज ग्रामर. या यू नीड टू बी वेरी मच एप्ट इन दैट, बट नॉट कम्प्लीटली. यू हैव टू बी अश्योर्ड दैट यू हैव टू बी वेरी मच प्रिसाइज. ट्राई टू बी. नहीं होता है तो खुद को ब्लेम रिग्रेट करने की जरूरत नहीं. इट्स नॉट अ पार्ट ऑफ योर जॉब. इनडायरेक्टली इट इज, बट वैसे नहीं. हाउ मेनी नॉवेल्स हैव यू रिटन? सो देर आर करंटली टू. One is the Benang Hills, and other than that, there is one more novel, which was a short love story. It was not a novel, but I would say it was a solo book, which had a story of 150 pages. It was a love story in a family drama. So I've written two. The Benang Hills is my prime one, which just released recently. It's a proper novel structure. It's a series, guys. It's a book series. The story does not have end in the first book. There, it's like a universe I'm making. Trying to build up my own. People may not accept it, people may not accept it. So as a writer, I have to even think like that. I have to prepare for myself for future things, like if my book is going to get published, I need to accept that people may like it and people may not like it. I have to accept both kind of people. And most of the people are liking it. I don't have to go on cloud nine. If I go there, my book will come down. The sales will drop, because you have to balance your ego in that. You have to balance your behavior in that. You have to be as much as you can on ground. Because writing is something you're writing for yourself, not for the people. People are reading it. They're just witnessing what you do for yourself. So be proud of that. Don't ever let the ego come in. Don't ever let yourself to take an imbalance on that road. Just be yourself. Go for it. How do I motivate myself when you face so many obstacles? How do I motivate myself? As I told you guys, one of the biggest motivation I always had was that just imagine, it's very subjective. Sheetal, this answer can be very subjective. But for many other people, motivation can be something else. For some people, motivation can be listening to the talks of Sandeep Maheshwari or Gaur Gopal Anand. For some people, motivation can be their parents. For some people, it can be people around them. It can be movies, get rid of negativity. So motivation is very subjective. And many people have their own ways, but the ideal way is to believe in yourself. For me, it was, as I said earlier, that the feeling is very different when you have that book in your hands and you see yourself name, you see your name printed on it. So whenever I used to write now, I had some of the other novels sitting beside me, whatever I could read that time. And if I'm feeling negativity, like I don't want to write, you know, like I just take that book in my hand and reimagine that what if it was mine? And what if the same book comes into the hands of my parents or the members of my family? How proud they will feel. So this was the strong motivation drive for me, which took, which kept me far from negativity, which is still doing that. For me, it's the people in my family who are proud. I could see the happiness, I could see the joy, exuberance in themselves. Ultimately, it's for the world I'm writing for, but the people I'm in touch with who care for me, who believe in me, love in me, and if they are feeling proud, hence that is the motivation for me to write more. And yes, for sure that it's I'm writing for myself, so I need to be proud. I will be, but you have to be selfless. Like, देखो दूसरे क्या सोचते हैं, उनकी खुशी अगर मिल रही है तुम्हारे लिखने से, that has to be a motivation. Not just family, can be anyone else. अगर किसी को तुम्हारे लिखने से खुशी मिल रही है, just imagine how they will feel when they see your piece of work printed, published, or anywhere else. So that is one of the most major ways that one can keep doing to keep negativity away. I hope I've answered that, Sheetal. Just an issue. Yeah, second guys, my laptop is facing an error. Thank you. So now one more thing. Now you have to think on marketing. See, as I tell you that evangelism is a type of marketing which always works for your books. So in the end of the journey, which when you have written the book, you have planned a storyline, it's going to get published, have a publication. For example, guys, if you having a book in your mind, so you can just go to SPS Publications and they do it really well. So you can just visit there and give your book published. So if you're doing for it, can be second subjective. अगर आप कहीं से भी कोई बुक पब्लिश करवा रहे हो, आपकी स्टोरी फाइनली लोगों के सामने आने वाली है, आप चाहते हो कि मेरी फैमिली, मेरे फ्रेंड्स के अलावा और भी लोग हैं जो बुक पढ़े, और भी रिकमेंडेशंस मुझे अनोन लोगों से, तो मैं क्या करूँ? हाउ कैन बी दैट मार्केटिंग पॉसिबल? इट इज पॉसिबल गाइस, इट इज वेरी मच पॉसिबल. एंड बट एनी मार्केटिंग, लीव इट फॉर इवेंजलिज्म, एनी मार्केटिंग बैरिंग फ्यू वंस, एनी इवेंजलिज्म require small investment. Marketing में you will definitely need to take an investment. A little bit for yourself, not much. You can just say that right now influence marketing is one of the biggest things which is happening in the world. So if you wish, you can send a bunch of copies around, people are reading it. You can send your books to certain influencers. If you want them, you can ask them to read it genuinely and post their review. You can tell them that you can send them your books. You can ask them to post a picture with that. Write a few words about how did they like it. You can create testimonials. Testimonials has to be the way for you, because until unless you get those, नहीं चलेगा. तुम्हारे अगर फैमिली में से अगर तुम्हारे मॉम ने ही बुक पढ़ी क्यों ना हो, टेक हर रिव्यू, टेक हर टेस्टिमोनियल एंड स्प्रेड इट आउट ऑन योर सोशल मीडिया. दैट इज वन ऑफ द बिगेस्ट मार्केटिंग थिंग्स फॉर मी. When I'm doing my evangelism marketing right now, where I'm focusing to let people face on the word of mouth thing, I'm posting reviews, because reviews is one of the ways of evangelism. Each of the members of my family who have जिसने भी पढ़ी है, जिसने भी पढ़ ली है बुक, मेरे फ्रेंड सर्कल में, इवन द पीपल जो अनलोन लोग हैं, जो मुझे मुझे जानते नहीं उतना, बट जिन्होंने बुक खरीदी मेरी, उनका जब मुझे इंस्टा पे DMs आते हैं या फेसबुक के मैसेजेस आते हैं. सो इट्स जस्ट दैट स्टोर देम ऑल और आई पोस्ट देम ऑन माई सोशल मीडिया यूजिंग हैशटैग्स, कैप्शंस, वेल फ्रेम, सो दैट लोगों को पता चले कि इतने सारे लोगों ने बुक पढ़ी है, उन लोगों ने ये रिव्यू दिए हैं, इट्स शायद वर्थ बाय. अगर ये सेम चीज इन्फ्लुएंसर्स के थ्रू हो सकती है, सो यू शुड डेफिनेटली ट्राई एंड अप्रोच सम, यू शुड डू सम PR. देयर आर इवन वेबसाइट्स गाइस, आई विल शेयर द लिंक्स इफ यू गेट इन टच विद मी ऑन इंस्टाग्राम. That help you get some news published. Even there is the Shade Room now there, which is launched by Guest, which is a news portal. So if your book is published, you can ask them to share an article about your book over there, get some views on it. And if you guys want to do some paid marketing, if you're ready to invest some of the other money, I generally never ever feel that it should be the right way, because but it's happening worldwide, which is very sad to see. It's like you can go for paid reviews, but a genuine writer, if you feel your story is genuinely nice, let it do its work. Today, even till date, guys, मुझे मुझे Instagram पे इतने DMs आते हैं, इतने लोगों के आते हैं कि यार मुझे रिव्यू करवाना है आपकी बुक में, रिव्यू करूँ, मैं इतना चार्ज करूंगा, मैं इतना चार्ज करूंगा, मैं रिव्यू कर दूंगी. बट दैट्स नॉट द केस. अगर ऐसा चीज होगा ना, तो इससेंस उड़ जाएगा यार. तो गो फॉर समथिंग विच इज येट कन्वीनियंट, येट फ्री, एंड मोस्ट इजिली इम्पैक्ट, जो ज्यादा अच्छे से इम्पैक्ट करेगा. द बेनिफिट विच आई हैड दैट आई वॉज इन वर्किंग इन मीडिया एंड एंटरटेनमेंट इंडस्ट्री, सो आई हैव वॉज इन टच विद लॉट ऑफ मीडिया इन्फ्लुएंसर्स, सेलेब्स एंड ऑल. सो इट वॉज इजी फॉर मी दैट दे वर लाइक फ्रेंड्स टू मी, सो आई जस्ट सेंड देम अ बुक एंड आस्क देम टू जस्ट पोस्ट समथिंग. सो इफ यू एंड इफ गाइस यू आर नॉट एबल टू डू दैट, इफ यू डोंट हैव द नंबर्स, इफ यू डोंट हैव द कनेक्ट्स ऑफ इन्फ्लुएंसर्स, a simple Instagram DM might work. Well, I was working in an entertainment agency. I used to get in touch with a lot of celebrities and influencers just by approaching them on Instagram. Just tell them that you are a writer, you want to promote, you want them to read your book and share your reviews. You can tell them that we have seen your profile and you're a great reader. So I've been following you since long time. You can just share it if I can send you an ebook or maybe a hard copy. Can you please share a story about it. Can you please read and find, tell me how was the book about? How did you find it? Try and go for the simpler and cheaper ways for the marketing, or else let evangelism do its work. I write under a pen name due to some reason. I want my identity to be a secret. Will this affect marketing? I do have an Instagram account under my pen name, which is rapidly growing. If you have a pen name which is working for you, क्या प्रॉब्लम है, रख लो. I still remember one of my very good friends who also turned an author last year. His name, his real name is something else, but in the books, he's like the guy. He was with the name of the God, something like that. So if a pen name is working out for you, it's great. And but I prefer that go for your real name. Most of the times that's how people will recognize you more, and that's how your personality, that's how your author brand will grow, that's how your author image will grow. Surely you will have split lives of professional and personal, but in here, when you choose a pen name, things might get a little bit complicated for the future in terms of balancing the two lives of being under the pen name and being under the name of something else. So, but it's not bad. You should go for it. If you think that growing, people are recognizing you by that, you have created that identity, without a question, you should go for it. You should write a story under that pen name. So it's completely fine for you. So, and if Pratit, if you're marketing your book by your pen name on your on that page of Instagram, then it will not affect. But if you are writing a book on your pen name and if you're promoting it on your personal profile, your personal handle, don't expect it to get that level of engagement it would get on your professional page. So you just need to use some of the other tricks of your mind, some sense to how you can balance the things. I hope I've answered you, Prakriti. So guys, we are in the Q&A session right now. So any of the questions in the last few minutes, you can just throw it out there and I'll try my best to answer you all. Anything it can be. It can be relating to just writing some small stories, quotes, excerpts. How can you utilize your writing skills? So just hit me up right now on the chats and let's have a fun Q&A. How many of you guys have literally had the idea, had the characters as well, but due to some of the other block could not write it? Was there anyone like that? जिनके पास कैरेक्टर भी था, स्टोरी भी थी, लेकिन ब्लॉक की वजह से लिख नहीं पाए? एनीवन लाइक फ्रॉम 10 people आई एम सीइंग हियर, सो व्हाट वाज दैट ट्रबल लाइक? इफ यू कैन जस्ट शेयर इट इन फ्यू लाइंस, इट विल बी ग्रेट. ये राइटर्स ब्लॉक आना नहीं, एक इट्स लाइक एक हक है, हर राइटर का एक हक है कि भाई हमको राइटिंग समझे, ब्लॉक तो आना ही चाहिए, उसके बिना तो कैसे होगा. सो इट्स अ प्रोसेस व्हिच हैपेंस. डोंट स्ट्रेच अ स्टोरी रूपल, नेवर स्ट्रेच योर स्टोरी. ग्रो योर स्टील, इट्स नॉट द राइट वर्ड. When you're facing a block, people, यही गलती मैंने भी करी है काफी बार, यही गलती बर्डिंग ऑथर्स यही करते रहे. एक पॉइंट आने के बाद यार लाइक यार ब्लॉक आ रहा है तो कुछ करते हैं, तो अननेसेसरी ना उस स्टोरी को खींचते जाते, दे ड्रैग द स्टोरी विच मेक्स इट बोरिंग. तो उस चीज में ना गाइस, जस्ट की रेदर देन स्ट्रेचिंग इट, डोंट यूज दैट वर्ड स्ट्रेच. हाउ विल यू ग्रो योर स्टोरी? क्या है? वही एलिमेंट पे, वही स्टोरी लाइन पे खेल के उसको खींचना, इट्स नॉट द राइट थिंग. तुम क्या नई चीजें डाल सकते हो उसके अंदर? कोई कुछ नए एलिमेंट्स डाल सकते हो, कुछ जो ऑलरेडी एग्जिस्टिंग है उसको तुम कैसे इवॉल्व करके उस स्टोरी को ग्रो कर सकते हो. ट्राई थिंकिंग ऑन ग्रोइंग योर स्टोरी रेदर देन स्ट्रेचिंग इट. सो दैट इज वन वे विच यू कैन थिंक ऑफ गेटिंग रीड ऑफ दैट. यू नो, ट्राई एडिंग न्यू एलिमेंट्स, न्यू पॉसिबली न्यू कैरेक्टर्स एज वेल, न्यू सब प्लॉट्स पॉसिबली. couldn't find a proper ending because the climax is the best part. So, Sheetal, that is very, very depends on what story you are writing. बहुत स्टोरीज में क्लाइमेक्स बीच में आता है, काफी स्टोरीज में क्लाइमेक्स कम्स इनटू द एंड. यूजुअली मोस्ट ऑफ द स्टोरीज में इट कम्स इनटू द एंड. सो इफ यू आर थिंकिंग दैट योर क्लाइमेक्स इज द बेस्ट पार्ट ऑफ योर बुक एंड शुड कम इन द एंड, डिजर्व इट. पूरे थ्रू ऑफ द चैप्टर्स भनक मत लगने देना कि ये चीज हो सकती है. एज आई सैड, हैव अ क्लिफ हैंगर, हैव अ क्लिफ हैंगर. ऐसे एलिमेंट्स डालो जिससे सस्पेंस बढ़े, जिससे रीडर का एंथुजियाज्म बढ़े कि हम, मुझे अब अगला चैप्टर पढ़ना है, मुझे ये चीज करनी है. ये स्टोरी के पढ़ने पूरे पढ़े बिना मैं सोने नहीं वाला आज. दैट इज समथिंग विच शुड कंसिस्ट इन योर बुक, ताकि वो जो क्लाइमेक्स विच यू आर पैनिंग इन द लास्ट शुड कम अप वेल. ओ आई एम करंटली पब्लिशिंग. ओ दैट्स ग्रेट यार, प्रतीक, कॉन्ग्रेचुलेशंस फॉर दैट. So, is it what kind of app is that if you're publishing over there? Will you get good audience over there? Do let me know, yeah. That's great. Congrats. What is it about for you? Priyoshi, like recently just got an idea and I've thought about it. Still researching a little about writing like characters. Have to start now. Don't rush, Priyush. Think, think. Give yourself some time. Don't think like अब मैंने थोड़ी रिसर्च कर ली, अब मैंने कैरेक्टर्स के बारे में सब पढ़ लिया, अब मुझे स्टार्ट कर देना चाहिए. नहीं, बिल्कुल भी नहीं. टाइम लो. अगर हाँ सफिशियंट डेटा है स्टार्ट करने के लिए तो बिल्कुल, नहीं तो लाइक तुम्हें लगता है कि नो आई नीड टू फाइंड लिटिल बिट मोर सर्च. Give yourself some space, give in be in that perspective of your mind that अब मैं चीज कर सकती हूँ, तो इट्स बेटर. डोंट रश, जस्ट डोंट रश फॉर योरसेल्फ. आई डिड पब्लिश माय इंस्पिरेशनल ब्लॉग इम्प्रेसो. दैट्स ग्रेट रूपल. मॉम्स प्रेसो इज अ गुड प्लेटफॉर्म फॉर पब्लिशिंग इंस्पिरेशनल स्टोरीज. आई रिमेम्बर in the starting phase of my writing, I used to write for newspapers like The Hindu, The Hitwada, if you know, The Indian Express. So I used to write inspirational articles for them. So it's a great start, Rupal, that blogs on such kind of platforms will always motivate you to write more. And trust me, while I used to write for The Hindu and The Indian Express, when people common मुझे लोगों के emails आते थे हिंदू पढ़ने के बाद, यस सर मैंने आपका ये आर्टिकल पढ़ा था हिंदू में और इट वाज सो गुड कि आज आई वाज आई यूज्ड टू रीड इंस्पिरेशनल ब्लॉग्स जस्ट लाइक यू रूपल. तो मुझे जब ईमेल्स आते थे लोगों से हिंदू में आर्टिकल पढ़ के पेपर में कि यार विजित सर आई हैव रेड योर आर्टिकल, आई वाज वेरी डिप्रेस्ड. वन गाय रोट टू मी दैट ही वाज प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर एन यूपीएससी एग्जाम एंड ही वाज वेरी स्ट्रेस्ड, ही डिड नॉट नो व्हाट टू डू. देयर वाज वन गर्ल आल्सो, आई डोंट नो हर नेम, आई विल नॉट डिस्क्लोज. Even though I know, so she personally texted me about her issues after reading the article in the newspaper. They were very much humbled and they had that motivation. So those people around you जो ऐसे ब्लॉग्स पढ़ेंगे, जो ऐसे आपको रिव्यूज देंगे, आपके ब्लॉग्स से नहीं, चाहे वो नॉर्मल स्टोरीज भी हो, आपको जब वो रिव्यूज देंगे, आपको मेल करेंगे, अपने रिलेटेबल उनको लगा या नहीं, वो चीजें बताएंगे ना, सो दैट इज द फैक्टर विच विल ड्राइव यू टू राइट ऑफ. जब लिखते जाओगे लिखते जाओगे लिखते जाओगे, आपके पास इतना एक्सपीरियंस आ जाएगा लिखने का कि नॉवेल लिखना आपके लिए कोई बड़ी बात नहीं होगी. इट विल बी जस्ट लाइक वन ऑफ दो स्मॉल थिंग्स विच यू डू इन योर एवरीडे लाइफ. दैट्स ग्रेट, दैट्स ग्रेट. लाइफ एंड एनीथिंग एल्स, आई वाज आई स्टिल राइट इन दैट जॉनर. I still write in a category because it's something which I started with, and you should never forget this thing which you once started and which made you something which you are today. So I will still do that. The app is called Chapter. It gives people platform for in an interactive manner. That's great. My book out to people who are trying to heal the wounds of that life has given them together. It's a slow burn romance. That's a brilliant genre, Praditi. That's one of the genres which is very less explored. There are some other stories I've read which are made on similar lines, which you have just point, but it's very niche. It's made for niche audience. It's about selective readers there. And it's really a challenging thing as to have a storyline which one can bend on. It's great, yeah, and kudos to you for planning this. Hope you write much more and get a hard copy of this soon in the near future, I think so. Because I want you to do that. If you've already done it on an ebook platform somewhere, so it's great. It will be great if you can do it in a hard copy way. What comments they have on? Okay. Even I'm a CSS parents never really asked this. It used to come in the Hindu popular, mostly it used to come in the opinion page section. Indian Express mein zyada nahi dikhenge, okay, it was on limited times only. Hitwada mein kaafi aata tha. Hindu mein it used to come on opinion page in every, I guess, 2 months or every 1 month. Kabhi kabhi to every month aate the. Kabhi every 2 months ek bar aa jata. So that's great. That's great, Rupal, that your story is got mentioned over there. It's Facebook sent and vocal is big. So if you want your articles to be published in papers like Hindu or any other, even Times of India, Hindustan Times, you need to approach them via mails. You need to tell them that you are writing, you want to write some columns for that. And if that's not the case, agar wo reply nahi dete, kafi baar yahi hoga ki wo reply na de. So you can just, unka ek section hota hai page mein, jahan pe aap free mein likh sakte ho, apne opinions de sakte ho. Probably in the opinion page there is, I would say, the expression page in the Hitwada. So wahan pe, then there is open space in one of the magazines I used to write for. So aisi wahan pe na aap अपना मेल में जो भी आप कंटेंट लिख रहे हो आप उनको मेल कर दो. द एडिटर विल सिलेक्ट योर आर्टिकल इफ इट्स गुड एंड इनफ व्हिच मैचेस विद द ऑडियंस ऑफ योर पेपर विदाउट इवन ट्राइंग हार्ड योर आर्टिकल माइट गेट पब्लिश्ड. बट इफ यू वांट स्पेसिफिकली टू राइट कॉलम्स व्हिच आई यूज्ड टू डू यू हैव टू अप्रोच देम बाय सम ऑर द अदर वे. इट कैन बी इन ईमेल, इट कैन बी बाय कनेक्टिंग विद द पर्सन ऑन लिंक्डइन. सो इट डिपेंड्स ऑन कंप्लीटली ऑन. I didn't have time. Only 3 months into writing, but still learning and growing. Even though if I have 20-25 years old, guys, writing, I will still grow. I will be learning. Because learning is never-ending journey. It is not over. Especially in terms of writing. I just imagine, guys. For any Indian author, if I am reading Ravindra Singh's book, which is like. I too had a love story, possibly. I don't remember the names of his books, but if it was I too had a love story. So when it came in 2010, maybe or 11, so it had a different sort of emotion. And if he's writing a love story today, of today's age of the 2021, it will involve technology. It will involve social media. It will involve the kind of situations are there in the world right now. So writer grows every time. 15 years later, there'll be the world will be completely changed. There might be flying cars around. Who knows? There is one right now which is testing happening in US. So, but who knows? There might be. So I might think of adapting that into my story. So writing is an ever growing journey. You need to evolve, match with the world, match with the pace of the world and grow. That's how it's going to happen. Rest being there at the same place and writing and writing, one get you to the place where you can be in the future. So, you need to evolve as a writer. Dekho kya trend chal raha hai. If I'm writing a story right now, which is written to social media, a guy and a girl, and social media ka mixture mein kuch element dal ke karta hu. So, the Clubhouse is the new big hot thing. And so, I need to try adapt Clubhouse. Kya main adapt Clubhouse ko adapt kar sakta hu meri storyline? Kya ye ek particular element aa sakta hai? Yeah, what if the guy in the community of Clubhouse? I know it has become a desi trend right now from a professional act, but just an example I'm sharing. So you need to evolve, you need to grow every single time when you come across. Thank you for your amazing session. Oh, it was amazing. I didn't know. मैंने तो बस वो चीज बोली विच आई फेस्ड इन माय ओन लाइफ विच आई फेस्ड इन माय ओन जर्नी आई डोंट नो इट वाज अमेजिंग और नॉट आई जस्ट शेयर्ड विच सी गाइस आई वाज लाइक या पहले आई वाज लाइक आई शुड प्रिपेयर अ प्लान फॉर यू आई शुड यू नो प्लान डाउन समथिंग और द अदर बट एट द एंड ऑफ द डे दोस थिंग्स डजंट मैटर इट्स व्हेन अ पर्सन शेयर्स वन एक्सपीरियंस टू अनदर दे विल फील दैट ओह यस दिस इज समथिंग विच आई नीडेड सो I just shared my experience. I tried to share what I faced, the problems, what kind of story I had thought on. And guys, whatever the story has to be, keep it to yourself. मतलब अपने दिल के पास रखना उससे दूर मत जाने देना कि वो आपका creation है आपकी दिल की कहानी है आपकी खुद की कहानी है चाहे वो लोग accept करें ना करें वो उनके ऊपर है आपकी story आपकी है और आपकी ही रहेगी Don't ever feel let down about your story. If your story is not doing good, just hope that it does not have that does not happen. But if your story, if you think it's not doing, your book is not doing well, don't feel bad. Learn from it, but keep that show to yourself because for every mother, regardless how the son is, they will love her mother will love him. You know, so it's just your own creation. Just do it that way. Oh, thank you so much, Muskan. It's not about being down to earth, yeah. Just that's the way I am. Thank you if you feel that way, and I'm really overwhelmed that. My words had a slice of motivation which poured into your ears. So thank you for being here because it's Sunday time. The first cricket match will happen on television. So you guys broke some time off and came here. Thank you very much. Thanks to you all, Rupal, Sheetal, I could there for your interesting questions. Priyoshi is there, Pratiti, for your kudos to your story. Thank you so much for being here. This really means a lot to me. And all of you guys, I'll really share a few of my, I'll share sample chapters of the book, which is out there on the Amazon. The initial chapters, I'll send you to all. I want you guys to read it, see how the storyline is. And if you like the story, if you think that the story is intriguing, please let me know. And if you want to purchase it, I will let you know how that as well. So, and because of that, you may even have possible chance of even getting an ebook for free from my hand. So if you want to listen to them, please do that freely. So sabko ek mere side se bina hai iske example coffee free milne wali hai. To mujhe batana aapke reviews ke hisab se. It will also make you feel connect to the type of experience I was sharing maybe. So the type of content and idea I had in my mind. So possible woh cheez hogi. And like it will be like an icing on the cake of what I just said all the time. May your creations, your writing leads to your dose of success. Thank you so much, Omer. Thanks for the great great comment. Yeah, Rupal, you can definitely do that. You can reach out to me on Instagram. You can reach out to me on my Instagram, my pen name. So one of the writers mentioned about pen names. Even I have a pen name. But I have not written my book on that pen name, but I even have a pen name page. I used to write my quotes and excerpts. So you can contact me there. I'll share my links with my IDs with you, which you can connect with me. So these are the handles where you can think of, you know, getting in touch with me, or I'll even leave an email if you want to drop an email over there and ask me out some questions if you have regarding some of the other things, which is relating to writing, stories, or anything else. And guys, it's COVID time out there, so please be safe. Please be in your home as much as possible. Try to wear double mask because that's the need of an hour. So I hope you guys are safe, your families are safe, your friends are safe, and most importantly, you are safe. Because लॉकडाउन चल रहा है, मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम्स हम घर पे है. यू कैन यूटिलाइज दिस टाइम गाइस. मैंने लॉकडाउन में सिर्फ फर्स्ट शिफ्ट मैंने अपनी स्टोरी पे काम किया था, क्योंकि वो टाइम था मेरे पास. पूरे टाइम घर पे था, ना काम था फिलहाल, तब कुछ. आई वाज नॉट इन लाइक आई वाज एट होम, आई वाज जस्ट इन द हाउस होल्ड चोर्स, नथिंग एल्स. सो इवन राइट नाउ सेम टाइप ऑफ टाइम इज गोइंग ऑन. भले इसमें ज्यादा उतना रिलैक्सेशन नहीं होगा, बट जितना भी होगा नॉर्मल रूटीन लाइफ से तो ज्यादा ही है. तो वो टाइम को अपने लिखने के लिए यूटिलाइज करो, सीखने के लिए यूटिलाइज करो, फोकस ऑन योर स्किल्स, वेदर इट कैन बी राइटिंग, ड्राइंग और एनीथिंग एल्स, बिकॉज इवन स्केचिंग ऑलवेज प्लेज अ बिग रोल इन योर राइटिंग. सो जस्ट फोकस ऑन दैट एंड यूज दिस टाइम, नीड्स आर, एंड होप यू ऑल आर सेफ गाइज. होप यू एंजॉय द सेशन. टेक केयर गाइज. See you soon. I hope you guys connect with me on Instagram and we stay in touch for future sessions if I take any. Thank you guys. Thank you very much.